See, this is the BIOS IC I have removed from this, so I'm going to reprogram it. This is the BIOS programmer. It is actually RT809F ISP programmer. So this adapter is not required for this IC. For other 8 pin IC, this adapter is required. I'm removing this adapter. Directly we can insert this IC. I have inserted the IC. I am connecting it to my computer. This is the RT809F software. I am opening it. That application has been opened. It is actually asking update. I'm cancelling this update. So this is the starting window. Here it is showing that serial number 20 something. That means the programmer has been connected. Now we have to click on this smart identity. Now it will show that chip is connected or not. Here see this, the currently selected W25 Q32V at SOIC8 capacity 32 MB, 4 MB, 4 MB. So this is the chip which was detected. First it has to be detected. If there is any loose connection or if it is not detected, it shows the error. After detecting the chip, if you want, we can read the program from the chip. I'm going to show how to read the program from the chip. For this, after identifying the chip, you just click on read option. The program is being read. See, it is asking the location and file name. I'm selecting the desktop. For example, I'm selecting the desktop. I'm giving file name as any name can be given. DLH61 I'm giving. After that, just click on save. This copied program will be saved into that particular selected location. Here I have selected the desktop. I have given the file name DLH61, right? So this is the software which was read, which has been read. Now I'm checking the properties. See, here it is showing 4 MB, 4 MB. This is the way how the program is to be read from the BIOS chip. Before reprogramming the BIOS, we must have the working BIOS program. First, we have to collect the BIOS program. There are many ways we can collect. Like from internet, we can download, or from working BIOS, we can copy. That means if we have the same motherboard on which the BIOS IC is okay, from that BIOS IC we can copy the program later on, which can be read into, written into corrupted BIOS chip. I have working BIOS program, so I'm going to write that working BIOS program into this particular chip. So for writing the chip, first we need to erase it. I am erasing this chip. See, the erase successful. So now after erasing, I'm checking whether is the chip is empty or not. Once again, I'm trying to read it. See, it is showing that the chip is empty. That means it was erased successfully. Now I'm going to write to write the program, to write the working BIOS program into this chip, first you need to load the working BIOS file. Actually, I collected that BIOS program, I saved in this particular location. I'm going to load that. See, for loading that working BIOS file, we need to click on open. See, actually, I have saved in this particular location. So this is the file. Select the file. This is the file which is working. File has been loaded. So after loading the file, we need to click on write option. See, this is right. We need to click on write option. So before writing, it erases the chip. After erasing the chip, the loaded program will be written into this particular chip. See, write successful, verification successful. So it has been written, that file, loaded file has been written successfully. Now we need to insert this BIOS chip into motherboard and check. So this is the way how the program is to be written into particular BIOS IC by using this RT809F programmer. I am disconnecting it.